Hey everybody, I hope everybody's having a wonderful week this week. So this week, what's popping and dropping is another request. And this request was made by Lauren C. And she asked if I could make a tunnel pop-up card for fall. And this is what I come up with. And I have never made a tunnel card before. This was my first one making it. Excuse the noise, guys. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but there's people outside working. So I'm going to just speak up a little bit. So anyways, this is the first one I made. And I just did a house way back in the back and a kitty cat up front. And when we go to make this, you can put these pieces wherever you would like. So why don't we go ahead and head over to Design Space and I'm going to show you what comes in the file. I'll see you there.
Okay guys, now that we are in Design Space, when you open the file up, it's going to look something like this. These are all the pieces that you will get in this file. If you want, you can go ahead and add any extra pieces that you would like to add to it. Don't forget to go up and name and save your project. So if you like, why don't we go ahead and get all of our pieces cut out and I'll meet you at the craft table and I'll show you how to put it together. I'll see you there.
Okay guys, now that we are back at the craft table, the first thing we're going to do is work our score line and then we're going to go ahead and put our pretty paper on. So why don't we go ahead and do that? Now we can get out our little center pieces, and what we can do is go ahead and put our little border around each one of them. So why don't we go ahead and do that? Our pretty papers and borders together, what we can do, I've already stacked them up so they're going in biggest to the smallest. And I'm just checking them again just to make sure. And we want on the big one, this larger piece that has the two score lines on our right side. And you can see we're going from big all the way down to the little. Before we go any further, let's go ahead and work all of our score lines. On this one, there's three, and on the rest of them, there's just two each, one on each side. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, so I have all my score lines worked. And this is what they will look like stacked up. And if you want, we can flip them over. If you have them in order, that's the easiest way so we know we're putting them on correctly. We're going to start from the smallest and work our way up to the largest. So figure out which side you want to be your front. This is going to be the front of my card. And so I'm going to get my first piece here. And what we're going to do is pick it up and turn it over. And when you turn it over, your left side should be the side that's in the score line here. And what we're going to do is this edge here is going to lay on the left side of our paper. We'll glue it on that. And we're going to bump it right up to that score line. And you want to get this centered in your score line too. So once you have it in place, we can put a little glue down. And again, we're gluing it to the left side of our paper. And you're bumping it right up into that score line. So whenever you have it lined up and ready to go and in place, you can just put glue down on your tab here and then fold the front of your card down. So let's go ahead and do that. So when you fold it back over, it should look something like this. Front of the card, and then it'll look like this, and then we'll fold it over to the right hand side. And we want to give that a good rub. And then we'll take our next piece and we'll place it down. It'll go like lay on top like so. And we're just going to do the same exact thing. We're going to bump it right up to our next score line, which would be this edge here. So you'll line it up. Once you get it in place, we'll fold it up, put glue on it, and then fold it over. Okay? So let's go ahead and do the next one. And there's our second one. And laying like this, they are going to look like they're not matching. That's okay. Don't panic. But when we go to put them on, if you set your card up like so, you'll see that it's lining up. I'm really liking these bright colors together. And then we can pick our next one up from our stack over here. Pick it up, turn it over like so, and then this is the lip we're gonna bump right up to the next one. So let's go ahead and do that. Pick up our next one, fold it over, put it on, and then line this edge up right in the next one. And let's go ahead and do our last two. And remember, you're still putting the small edge on this one on the same side. So this edge should end up over here. So let's do that. All right, isn't that looking neat? So the fun part is we get to start decorating stuff. So you can place your items anywhere you want. You just want to be able to see them when, as you look down the tunnel of the book. But if you want to follow along with what I'm doing, we can sure do that. I am going to put my house at the back. So I'm going to get my house together and then I'm going to put it on the back and I'm just going to kind of center it in my last box. So about right there, I can see just about all of my house. So I'm going to go ahead and glue mine down there. And then from here, you just start building up to your next one. So if you fold it up like this, you can get an idea of where you want to put stuff. And I do know for sure on the front, I want my fence. And you could put the fence if you want it on the next one. It's just totally whatever you like. So I think on my second one, I'm going to put the spider web over here in the corner with a spider on it. And then on my next one up, I think I want some bats. So I'm going to just kind of eye it and see where I like it. Now for my tree, if you want to put it on either side, what I did is I just figured out where and how much of it I wanted. And then I just snipped it off. I think I'm going to do like so. And have him right up to the edge here. And then I might take this piece and use it somewhere inside. Let's see. Yeah, I think that's what I want to do. I want to put it over there on that edge over there. I like that. And you can keep this as simple as you would like, or you can keep adding more layers to it on the inside of each layer. it's really up to you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and put my stuff on my cat. All right, so if you're ready and have yours all finished, what you're going to put on it, we can lay it down and put it to this side. So we want everything past this big flap. So the other four of these. So we're going to take our four leftover flaps, put glue on those, leaving these laid flat, and then we're going to glue them down to this section here, not our little tab. And if you're like me and you went past this little tab here, so I have some green sticking out, so what I do just to be safe is I just go and snip a little off, because I cannot, as you guys know, lay anything straight. I try, but it never happens. So anyways, we're going to put it down on this, so I'm not going past my tab with any of my green over here, so I'm good. So let's go ahead and put glue on these tabs. So we have the glue. These are all laying flat. I have my little tab up so we don't glue that down by accident. We're just going to lay it down. And then we're going to give it a nice, good rub. So then once we have it all together here, we're going to lay it back nice and flat, like so.
Put glue on our tab.
And then we're going to bring this page over to it. Okay, so let's do that. And then we open it up and we have our cute little book. Nifty, nifty, and it lays nice and flat. Now I'm going to go ahead and finish up the rest of my decorations on here, and then I'll be back to show you my finished product. Guys, so here is the finished card. But before we go over the card, I wanted to do the envelope really quick. It does have a double score line, and that is for a gusset for the card, so it can fit nicely in there. So you'll just work your score lines as usual, and then there will be a double one on it, so you'll have like this edge, like so. And then once you have the score lines folded, you'll see we have this nice little extra room for the card to be able to fit nicely into. Then we're just going to take glue or tape and adhere to this side, these two flaps, and then bring one of your ends up and adhere it to that. And then we have our envelope. Now for our card, I did this cute little face on the front. And when you put this guy on, we don't have a lot of room left in the envelope, so you want to put it as close as you can to the edge of your card. So we have this cute little pumpkin face on the front, and then we open it up and it says Happy Fall, y'all. And then we have this nice tunnel card with all this extra goodiness on the inside. We have some trees, spiders, pumpkins, bats, spider webs, And you could do all kinds of cute little things with this. You could even add something over on this side. And then on the back, I just did a place where you could write a message, and I did a pumpkin. And I think this turned out pretty cute, guys. And thanks again to Lauren C. for suggesting this. We might have to do another one of these. You guys know why did the apple pie cry? Because his peel wings got hurt. Guys, I want to thank you so much for stopping by and crafting with me. Don't forget to stop by next week to see what's popping and dropping. Bye.